I find it amazing that here we are with some of the most egregious amount of gun violence that we've had in generations, that we're still having a conversation on whether or not Pennsylvania should be in charge of our own public safety and whether or not we should use our own data to determine whether or not somebody should legally and lawfully own a firearm. I find it to be absolutely fascinating, because the word I would actually choose to use would not be appropriate for this hearing. I had the largest mass shooting in my city's history last year, where 10 people were shot outside of a nightclub. Two of the firearms used would not have been eligible for some of the background checks because they were long rifles, let me rephrase, AR-15s. One of them was an illegal pistol. Regardless, it is just absolutely shocking to me that we're still wondering whether or not we should have a firearm check system of our own, which by your own testimony includes at least 1,500 people that should not have access to a firearm through the PFA check system. So thank you, gentlemen, for standing up for the safety and security of Pennsylvanians across the Commonwealth. Continuing on the topic of the funding of the PICS system, can you elaborate briefly, please, on how much you're seeking in that additional federal grant? That's the first time I've heard that information.
We don't have an exact estimate because we're in the process of working with a vendor and working with ATF to ensure that we're compliant. And then once we have the parameters, the requirements gathering done, then so we don't actually know what the cost will be.
Somewhere between zero and $5.7 million, apparently.
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. Fair enough. I keep hearing that the onerous cost of the $5 for a purchase of a firearm might be high. I'm still shocked by this, but the actual cost is roughly $10 to $11 per background check, and that was a Legislative Budget and Finance Commission report that came out a couple of years ago. Those numbers are still approximately right, correct?
Yes, sir. LBFC is mandated per the law to do that evaluation every 5 years. I think we're actually due next year. I think we're due 2020 for the next evaluation.
Okay. So because the cost to the firearm purchaser is $5, the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania is subsidizing roughly 1 million gun background checks to the tune of an additional $6, roughly equaling to $5.7 million. And that $5.7 million of subsidy from other taxpayers, like me, comes out of a general fund appropriations, correct?
Some of it, yeah. I believe PICS is three sources. It's GGO, gun checks appropriation, and then the PICS fees are the three funding sources.
Okay. So now, conversely, the conversation about raising this fee, which hasn't been raised since, 1997, 1998, when the program came into existence in the first place, by the way, I was still in college, and I'm now in my 40s. The additional fee is not translated into what a gun dealer actually charges, correct? So a gun dealer has to remit up to $5 to the Commonwealth for this. But they could charge whatever administrative fee they choose to on top of it, right?
That's correct, sir, yes.
Okay, so a gun dealer somewhere in the middle of Pennsylvania or in one of our urban cores or anywhere would remit up to $5, assuming it's a taxable sale, to the Commonwealth. But they could charge $25, $50, $100. They could call it an Obama tax if they want to. They could call it a Tom Wolf tax if they want to. They could blame the Commonwealth for it. But they're really only transmitting up to $5.
That's correct, sir, yes.
Okay, so we could, in theory, do two things simultaneously, which is fund the PICS system from the actual users of the PICS system, which are those people that are purchasing firearms, and yet at the same time protect firearm owners or purchasers from what I would consider price gouging from some, certainly not all, probably not many of them, but a certain number of gun dealers who might be charging an absorbent administrative fee on top of it. We could choose to do something like that, correct?
I think that's a legislative project.
When I said we, I meant us on this side of the table. But there's nothing that would accomplish your goal of making sure it's funded, so we're not pulling another, $5.7 million out of the general fund. And yet, at the same time, theoretically protect a gun purchaser from absorbing the costs on top of it.
Again, sir, I would defer to the legislature.
That's our decision, not yours. I understand. All right. So And I just want to, before my time's up, because the yellow light's coming on, I just want to make sure I heard that correct. Last year, you processed over 900,000 background checks in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania?
That's total. Firearms transfers are actually about 700,000. The remainder are, we do license to carry checks for sheriff's departments and also evidence returns.
And how many people were denied access to a firearm because of our PICS system?
I don't have an exact number right in front of me. It was over 10,000, I believe.
That's very important. Thank you, gentlemen, for all you do to keep our community safe.